This is the same red hospital. It's not too far from our home in Bangkok. We want to visit the monkeys in a town called Lop Buri. And there's something we need to do first, as a precaution.
If you're going adventuring with monkeys, you need injections first. A monkey bite can give you rabies, and hepatitis B. You really don't want to get that.
Okay, Mom. How's
it? I'm feeling good. It hurts, but I don't mind it hurt. It can save your life.
Lop Buri is about 150 kilometers northeast of Bangkok. It's a very old town that dates back 1,000 years. Today, Lop Buri is really well known because there are thousands of crab-eating macaques that live in the middle of the city, especially around the temple. We've chosen to stay in a hotel right in the middle of the town where the monkeys live. The hotel was covered everywhere with monkeys. Through the window of our hotel room, I got up close to monkeys for the first time in my life. They climbed all over the protective fence wire that the townspeople in this area put over their homes as protection from the monkeys. It had rained all night and was still raining in the morning. Some monkeys huddled tightly together as a family to keep warm. Others dashed about and played on the slippery roofs. Mum began sketching the monkeys clinging onto the wire. Us looking at them, looking at us. There are monkeys everywhere of all ages. Even the babies have the confidence to climb high. But their mothers are always close by to protect them. I guess most people on the outside see monkeys in cages in zoos. Here in Lop Buri, it's the exact opposite. In normal times, the macaques live happily with humans, because they get fed good food by animal-loving visitors. Since the pandemic, there aren't any visitors. The monkeys have been scavenging for months for junk food, and their behavior is said by the locals to have changed. Next to our hotel, there was an office selling bus tickets to Bangkok. Next to a bus driver waiting for travelers that didn't come was an old macaque called Kom by the locals. He was surely a high-ranking macaque in his day. Due to his advanced age, had lost his dominance and huddled outside the office each day for human protection from the attacks of younger dominant males. At the end of the sketch, another macaque, less friendly than Kom, came by. He tried to steal my mom's sketchbook. Macaques have learned to steal from humans and will only return their possessions in exchange for food. I could see a shrine out of our hotel window where many monkeys live. It has a busy road around it, and somehow the monkeys have adapted to city life, mingling with fast-moving cars and scooters. Even the train runs through it too. Alongside very playful and mischievous monkeys, we could see mothers with their babies. Babies are born with black hair, which turns brown around 3 months old. I saw macaques in family groups groom each other, very gently. We met another old monkey sheltering next to the lottery ticket sellers. She relies on them to protect her from sudden attacks from monkeys with aggressive behavior. On the opposite side of a busy road from the hotel is an ancient Buddhist temple called Krabang Samyot, which means three-towered temple. It dates from the 13th century. The monkey is considered a sacred animal in some temples. This temple is home to many hundreds of macaques. It's a little more peaceful here. The color of the monkey's fur blends in with the old weathered stone walls and Buddha. Macaques have lived alongside humans since prehistoric times. Here in the temple, I could feel what life must have been like in centuries gone by. Just around the corner from our hotel, opposite the temple, is a shop that sells spare parts for cars. We had a meeting with the shop owner, the governor of Lopburi, a fine arts professor, and a number of kind volunteers that want to help with our project to play piano for the macaques. But that meeting is another story. The shop owner is called Dong, and he, his family, and in-laws love monkeys, and each day run their business with many monkeys in and out of their shop. Due to the pandemic, the monkeys are hungrier than usual, so they feed them and have a strong bond with the number that moved into the shop and call it their home. It's a safe haven for a number of very small and old macaques. We will put a piano in his shop in November and just see what happens. Who knows? Maybe this old macaque will like music. Thanks to Dong and his family, these macaques that live around the temple won't go hungry. They have been feeding them before the pandemic and will continue to feed them for as long as it lasts and people stay away. It's time to leave our hotel in Lopburi and return home to Bangkok. Meeting these wonderful macaques for the first time has been unforgettable. I love monkeys and can't wait to come back to see them again in November with Daddy's piano. Who knows what will happen? Thanks for watching. Please stay safe and well.